So 13 points between Yunzhu Liu and Katie Spartchikov. How does Spartchikov play this?
Trying to keep nose clean, really. It's one of these positions where she's got everything breathing down her neck and trying to do so. But again, it depends on how Liu really sort of plays this. If she goes out as a full attacking force on that to protect her gold, then that would be something that she's then going to have to deal with and be a very different setup for what she's going to do. But it's going to be one of those ones where, you know, Sophia Parkner behind, Peacon behind, Emma Wilson, they're all there sort of breathing down her neck, that the opportunity is there that she could slip up. And so she's the one in the position where actually she looks in a really good setup, but actually is the one that could end up losing most.
Yeah, so I'm looking forward to see what's going to happen, whether or not she's going to attack or not. I mean, it would make sense that she would try to do something, as Spartchikov is the only person that can keep her from winning the gold. But in these conditions, it's obviously very hard to do, and it's really hard to control another boat when there's waves this big and it's blowing 20 knots.
So
that's 4 minutes there going up.
That'll be interesting. We've got looking at the breeze again. We're starting to see it click. It's been jumping around a little bit more, but it's starting to flick left a little bit more. We're starting to see a couple of 195s creep in. Nothing too significant. It still keeps coming back to that 200. So there is a little bit more movement across that sort of wind range. Breeze still up. We're seeing up to 20 knots. And so again, these boards are going to absolutely fly around. And the trickiest bit is going to be these waves. They're going to be the hardest bit, how you manage to move around them, trying to identify sort of the speed they'll be doing up downwind will be radically different to the speed that they'll be doing upwind and picking their way through those waves. But at the moment, again, that wind just starting to favor that left side a little bit more again, but no significant side.
So with 2 minutes and 40 seconds to go, let's have a look at how they line up going into this medal race. 10 races completed this week in order to qualify for the medal race. And Yunzhu Liu has a sizable lead. That means she could slip out of the gold medal position, but she will win at least the silver medal. Close battle for bronze there. The top five as well could all win silver mathematically anyway. So that's all the way down to Great Britain's Emma Wilson. And the top seven are all in the hunt for a bronze medal. So we're into the 2 minute window now. And we can start picking out some of our leaders. Yunzhu Liu of China, she's number seven. We've got three Chinese sailors in this medal race, Yu Tan and Paina Chen as well.
We should just pick up, really, there's a different course configuration. So they are going to start. We see them clustered up here to the right of the start, and it's a reaching start. So they're going to appear from that picture. They'll be blasting through across on the starboard jibe up to a windward mark, bearing away a downwind to a leeward mark, back up to that windward mark for a first time. Turn down to the gate at the bottom, back up wind, and then a final reach across the top. So it's like a T-shaped course. So a reaching start, difficult to when to hit that accelerator. You want to be hitting that line at full speed. So when to pull that accelerator. And here are those the gold and silver medalists currently sitting side by side. Liu just keeping her focused on exactly where Spartchikov is. Bykachov just trying to drift slightly to leeward and put some separation between them. Little bit of a bias towards that pin end as well. The question will be, is it a good enough line into that first mark? They'll be able to hold a higher angle and maintain a higher speed. But with these waves, it is having that opportunity to bear off as well.
Here we go then, the first women's RSX medal race of a brand new Hempel World Cup Series season. Counting down, and they are blasting into that start line, and they've got to get it exactly right. But look at them go. The race is underway, and at some speed here in Enoshima, and the Japanese Yuki Tsunaga across the line first, and no doubt getting a cheer from the fans on the breakwater watching from a distance.
It was a great start as well from British Emma Wilson, sort of down towards that pin end, but this is where it closes in at this mark to how those ley lines pick up before they bear off.
And this is our overnight leader, Yunshu Liu, trying to make her way back up the fleet as Yuki Tsunaga leads the charge upwind. Downwind they go, Yuki Tsunaga out in front, Yue Tan and Sofia Nacetyk-Lopaka of Poland in third.
Yeah, Tsunaga definitely in the lead because she crossed the starting line 2-3, maybe even 4 seconds before the rest. So and then was able to just go straight to that mark and go downwind.
Well, and that's the challenge of those reaching starts, being at full speed when you hit that line, but gauging when that speed's going to come on. And it's not like you're hitting it at a constant speed. That wind's changing all the time. The waves are changing to how you do it. But really interesting conditions now. Starting to slide back. Tsunaga there sort of just struggling with maintaining the pace against the Chinese. Tan sort of out in front. Look at the speed sort of gap and just creating that gap. Seems to be really at home in these wavier conditions.
So our leader there currently hitting around about 20-21 knots of speed. And Yuki Tsunaga considerably slower, as the pictures tell. There you can see confirmation of the speed on the left corner.
Bykachov, I believe, say with the blue bib. As you see how much it is really sort of bouncing around on that sort of downwind leg and how physical this is. Every single shock going through that body, maintaining that speed. But look at the speed coming in from these boats. Now they've got on this port jibe. They've now got that power of the waves pushing them downwind as well. So really, really exciting stuff as these guys, they are flat out downwind.
Yeah, and Yunshu Liu, she was actually starting above everybody else and was able to go to the side on that downwind and then just made a perfect ley line going towards that gate. And that's how she gained, I think, 5 places on that downwind. And is now rounded first through the gate.
So the whole fleet are through that gate now. And Yunshu Liu is out in front. Okay, so we're looking upwind now, and you can see a split in the fleet there, with our overall leader going to the right-hand side, followed by the Brazilian. But the pole in third has gone to the left-hand side of the course. Spychikov sticking with Yunshu Liu. So the current silver medalist staying close and within sight of the leader.
Yeah, so pretty much everybody that is in a good position in the leaderboard is going towards the right-hand side, and we have Polish Klepaka Zofia, who is going towards the left-hand side. That's the current situation, and it looks like the right-hand side is definitely gaining a little bit. We were down to 190, and now we're back up to about 200, so about a 10-degree shift towards the right.
Is our leader second at the Europeans this year. And Lou started the year with a victory in the Hempel World Cup Series in Miami. And the 3D graphic is the best way of keeping up with these windsurfers. They're going so fast right now. But it gives us a great bird's eye view as they head towards that third mark at the top of the course.
Really brings in sort of how confident you have to be on your strategy, where you want to be going, because, you know, at this middle section of the course, you're at the furthest point away from where you could be from a competitor at that wider section. And so if you've chosen to go towards the right-hand side, and this is exactly Lou just going for attack now out on that right-hand side, you've got to be 100% confident that's where that breeze is, that's where the wind shift is, and you're happy on that right-hand side. If you're unsure, you're doing those tacks in the middle, and but we've not seen the shifts come in. It's all still fairly stable. This breeze sitting around 19 knots again. The odd little gust coming in of a knot or two more. So again, that stabilization all in play. And again, it's just Lou keeping an eye on Katie Spykachoff, who's just taken a following sort of route behind her, taking on towards this right-hand side. So at the moment, for Lou, it's all playing into her hands after a superb downwind leg. Just maximum speed on that right-hand side. Picked a nice lane all the way through to the gate. But still very challenging conditions and very physical as we head upwind.
Challenging conditions, but whatever the conditions, Lou has really shone here in Enoshima. She won the Olympic test event last week. She's well in the lead in this medal race. And, well, I don't think she's been out of the top five at all this week in the qualifying races. So Yunju Lou in top form right now, and her teammate Paina Chen has now moved into second place. We were talking about the importance of strength in depth for training and preparing for the Olympics. Well, the Chinese women's RSX team are really, really strong. Be interesting to see which one of them goes to the games in the end. And let's not forget Paina Chen, silver medalist in Rio, world champion a couple of times. So hugely experienced, but being challenged all the way for that Chinese place at Tokyo 2020.
Again, that right-hand side just settling in, whether that's sort of looking at the breeze. Breeze flicking slightly towards that right, but again, nothing too significant, just a few degrees, but that's what they're after. A lot of the group and that arrow-headed fleet sitting out towards that right-hand side, minimizing maneuvers, minimizing the tacks from where the board slows down, a chance where you can get bumped off that sort of a position and a chance to drop that rig, which would suddenly be detrimental to how the race course is. And Lou looks set here. We just caught a glimpse of the windward mark in play, so currently sitting happy on that line. You can see the waves just bumping her and wanting to push slightly to leeward of where that mark is, but at the moment looks all set for around. We can see the mark in shot. Will she shoot the mark and just carry a slightly higher angle, whether it's going to require another maneuver? And that's it. That one big wave, big sort of a slap into the body and forcing her to go for that double tack right in front of the rest of the fleet. Now she's off the board, struggling. She's drifted the other side of the mark. So now she's got to do a double tack again. So this is all now. She's in the water.
Well, who would have thought it? Yunju Liu has gone into the water. Patricia Freitas has taken the advantage. And Paina Chen is round as well as the rest of the fleet. Round that top mark, that final mark.
He was just a little short on that ley line.
I've just got her angles completely wrong. And you can see she's now approaching that mark once again and making another attempt. Yuki Tsunaga of Japan, though, moved up to fourth, giving the home fans something to shout about. Here's Katie Spychakov, who started the day second overall and currently still holding that silver medal. Let's have a look, when we can, at that round that mark rounding once again. Just how disastrous was this? So she was basically just drifted off the ley line there, didn't she?
Well, she was just probably under it on that first attempt. Could have been a little bit more. The waves just bumped her. Tried to sail a slightly higher line. We talk about shooting the mark, which is just trying to sail above the angle that you'd normally be at just for a short period of time to get you around that mark. But that one wave hit the body, slowed that speed, put her off balance, and that's where decisions go into that second double tack. But when she came out of that second tack, that board just drifting away from her. You could see her in the water, trying to water start. And by the time she came back upright, was again that leeward side of that mark. Trying to throw again, that's when the pressure starts to mount. That's when it all starts. Urgency kicks in. Trying to recover. And so caused her to slip off the board once more.
I think
more.
She was a bit unlucky also. I think she did a double tech and then she was caught in dirty air by Patricia Freitas and Spychakov. And that's why she, you know, she just didn't make it again.
Let's not write her off, though, because although we're watching Paina Chen heading down down this leg, Yunju Liu is blasting her way back into the running, is in seventh place, doing 21 knots right now, and that is still good enough to hold on to the gold medal position. So Paina Chen leads from Patricia Freitas and Katie Spychakov. And in fact, despite the drama, we've seen no change in the actual medal positions.
Yeah, that's true. But that's also because Liu had a 13-point lead advantage, which is quite a lot in the medal race. And she's still in seventh position, so she still has a 5-point lead over Katie Spychakov.
Downwind, they've got to come back upwind. So as they come down towards that gate mark, they'll make their way back upwind for that final upwind leg, and then they've got a short reach across the top. So how they started, but the opposite direction. They lead. Now you can see that gold bib heading back out towards that right-hand side. In seventh place, recovered, and now just got to maintain speed back up through the fleet, but still holding on to gold. Paina Chen, teammate at the front of that fleet, rounded the same mark, heading out towards that right side of the fleet as well.
Yeah, and almost everyone more or less going towards that right-hand side now. I think there might be maybe a little bit less big waves on that side, a little bit closer to the shore. That's maybe why they can go a little bit faster on that side, because it doesn't look like there's so much wind shift or there's so much change in direction.
No, there's a clear commitment from all of them towards that right-hand side, and the SAP sailing analytics aren't identifying anything specific with the breeze. It is starting to creep round towards that right. There's probably as big as opportunity from that breeze round towards that right than we've seen during the race. So again, it's just maybe just enough, 5 degrees around towards that's enough, just settling down. You're just going to try and make any gains possible.
Patricia Freitas of Brazil, currently sitting second in this medal race. She was the World Cup Series champion back in 2017, sealing that victory in Santander. That's been her greatest moment as far as the World Cup Series is concerned. She had to take time out with injuries to her knees and elbows at the end of that season. And this really is the beginning of her comeback. And that's Pena Chen, just below Patricia Freitas, heading off with her to that, up the course.
Again, a dominant sort of side with that group. The one thing it does do is it opens up the boards towards the left-hand side. They might not be on exactly the favoured side, but what they do have is clear air, less disturbed air from the other boards, clearer sort of water in that sort of sense, because enough disturbed air from water from those other boards. So it does put sort of chance into people like Emma Wilson, who's over towards that left-hand side, and see whether they can make a game back in towards the competitors, bring themselves back in.
Well, we're watching Lou, overall leader, trying to make her way back up through the fleet. Yuki Tsunaga to the right-hand side of the picture. And Charlene Picon is making an appearance in the top half of the fleet for the first time in this medal race.
But again, you can see the kind of conditions that they face, is that trying to just keep that board under control there. Tsunaga, just you can see the angle of that board. Every time it hits that sort of wave, it wants to lift, air goes underneath it and wants to lift that board, but it creates that angle sort of change on the board and the direction that you then have to take, dropping the nose of the board down, taking a slower a lower angle, and that's exactly what sort of caught Lou out at that top mark. So many of them, as they just pitched up underneath that that ley line at the moment to give them that opportunity to tack, but they won't certainly be holding it too late towards that mark to put them under pressure. They want to be able to tack back in clear towards that top mark and give themselves time to set up for the bearaway. And then it's a flat out reach towards that finish line.
And we were hearing from sailors in some of the other classes as well about the strength of the wind, you know, lifting their boats in the 49er and the Nacra, and how they were having to constantly react to the battering of the waves, but also being lifted by the wind. But it's Pena Chen out in front in this medal race. Currently out of the running for a medal as things stand. Patricia Freitas and Pena Chen coming into this mark.
We should see Chen approach from the opposite side.
There she is. And so Chen is going to come into this mark out in front. But she had a much bigger lead earlier on, and Patricia Freitas has done so well to stay in touch and to challenge. And it's a difficult one to call, this, as they head towards the finish line.
Look at this. This is just sheer speed. Who can maintain that speed? It's a difficult position for Patricia Freitas to be able to come through to Leward here. But look at the speed and the control.
So they cross the finish line. Pena Chen wins the medal race. Freitas takes second. But it looks like the medals will remain as we started, with gold going to Yunxu Liu. Now let's follow them in. So it's a third place finish for the pole. And that means a bronze medal for her. She started in third. She finishes in third. The bronze medalist from London 2012 takes bronze here in Enoshima. Here comes Katie Spychakov. And that should be good enough for silver. Great Britain's Emma Wilson in fifth. And the home windsurfer, Tsunaga, finishes. A little cheer from outside the studio as the spectators saw her cross the line. But Yunzhu Liu of China rounds off a fantastic couple of weeks by winning gold. She's done enough. She did enough, really, in the build-up to this medal race with five victories already under her belt. And that was enough. Despite falling in the drink in the medal race, she'd already done enough to take that gold medal. So Yunzhu Liu takes gold here in Enoshima to add it to her gold in the Olympic test event last week. And that is her second victory in the Hempel World Cup Series. Some real speed there, and drama and entertainment. We've had it all, really, in these medal races today. Okay, Corky, take us through that race.
Okay, so a slightly different start. Let's fly down scene one and have a look at that start. So reaching start. So it all came down to time and distance, when to judge it. And it was the Japanese sailor, Tsunaga, that basically came away nicely at that bottom bit. You can see sort of a couple of boat lengths forward on anybody else. Emma Wilson did a good job off that pin end as well. And then they all converged in on that first mark before that bear away and downwind. So this is where it's different from the other fleets. These are all flat out across to that first mark. And then you can watch this bear away. Look at all of the 10 boards all packed in. Now the bear away goes downwind, but the speed then just multiplies. This was where Liu really sort of capitalized. Coming down that right-hand side, she maintained a really good position, good speed all the way down. Nice jibe in towards that right-hand side corner. And that brought her into scene two. So we'll look at that leeward gate. And there we are. So they came down. Liu led at that gate. So made that jump forward by just keeping a little bit more speed on. Took that right-hand side. We see Freitas heading out towards that right side. And also Liu keeping an eye on Spychakov. She was the one that was the only one that had real chance of taking any medal away. So Liu keeping firmly in control on that right side. So a bit of a split there, but again, that right hand side being quite a favoured side. So let's jump to scene three, and this is where it all became really tricky for Liu. So she came off the board, came in late from that leeward mark. Then we saw the double tack, got bumped on that. And this is where we just saw front of picture there, Spychakov make the gain sort of forward. But cool, calm, collected, reset, gets back into that, and we can see those leaders around. As Liu was fought away, she dropped back to seventh, but that really showed what the true testament of a champ. Wiped that clean from it, mistakes happened, and then settled back in. Let's spin forward to scene four and have a look at how things looked at that gate mark. So right down at the bottom, teammate Painter Chen led round with the Brazilian Freitas right behind. And they had a hell of a battle all the way through. A lot of the fleet all favouring that right-hand side. A little bit of a right-hand shift, only sort of about 5 degrees, but more more significant than that they've had across the whole course. Spychakov round in third. And so all these boards headed out towards that right-hand side. Spin forward to scene five, and we catch that windward mark and this phenomenal finish. So here they are, Painter Chen coming in on port, tacking in, and you see how close the gap is between these two lead boards. That's the windward mark. You can see the waves, the board gun, the bow comes down on Painter Chen's, and now this was what we saw, a dramatic drag race towards the finish line. So amazing drone flying, keeping up with the speed of these two as they were going down 22, 23 knots of speed as they were coming down this reach. And you can see them head to head, looking at each other, identifying exactly who's going to cross that line. They know that one bad mistake, one bad wave could put it and change how things are going. But Painter Chen managed to hold on and cross that line at first. Patricia Freitas in second. A great result for both of those, but it didn't shake up the medals. Lou was gained a place up into sixth, and that was good enough for gold. Spykachov across the line in fourth was for silver, and then Cleopatra Sofia in third for bronze.
Painter Chen, winner here of the medal race. But celebrations are by Yunju Liu.
Celebrations by Yunju Liu, our gold medalist here in Enoshima. She celebrated victory in the Olympic test event last week and now here in the Hempel World Cup Series. And there she is, flying the Chinese flag as the battle within the Chinese team continues for a place in the Olympics in a year's time. Confirmation of the results now. And really, the medals remain as we went into the race with Yunju Liu going in with such an advantage that even... falling in the water meant that she couldn't be caught. Katie Spychakov gets silver and Zofia gets third for Poland. And Painter Chen, that victory in the medal race, moved her up from seventh to fourth overall.